Hello guys, welcome back to Let's Play Dark Souls 2 Scholar of the First Sin Edition with me, Crudeless. How are you guys doing today? I'm doing amazingly well, having a great day today. Just got up and want to play some more Dark Souls 2. Man, I took a break over the weekend and coming back here to Majula feels kind of nice, don't you think? In the last episode, we defeated the Duke's dear Freya and we got ourselves this amazing soul right here. The soul of Duke's dear Freya. But I promised you guys that we were going to check out what this Brightstone key, what this led to. So I'm going to do just that. And I'm also going to level up with the points we got from the boss. So let's do that. The one thing I didn't really cover well in the first episode was adaptability as a stat. Now, adaptability, as you can see, increases all the resistances except for bleed, which is increased by something else, I think. Dexterity, I guess. And you can see that it increases those stats as well as poise and agility. Now, agility is actually a really important stat. It boosts ease of evasion and other actions. Really, really obfuscated what that really does. It isn't really transparent. But what it does is that when you do rolls, basically, you have some invincibility. So when I do a roll there, in the first, 0.1 second there, I'm invincible to damage, basically. And that is not determined by the fact or by the equipment weight. The only thing that equipment weight determines, when you're below 70%, of course, because that's when you slow roll, that's how far you roll. So you can see I'm rolling pretty far. If I equip something heavy, like this Cyan armor here, you can see my rolls are a little shorter. So that's nice, that's good to know. So adaptability, adaptability does increase agility. So agility will increase that that invincibility frame, that frame of invincibility that you have during a roll. So if you have, as currently we have 89 agility, which is not good. It caps at about 110, and it's usually nice to have it around level around 100 or 105. Maybe 95 to 105 is the window you should aim for. And it will be increased by increasing attunement. So we have a bit more because we have increased attunement, as you can see. But adaptability increases it further. Agility also increases how quickly you raise a shield and how fast you drink an Estus flask, which is nice. So as of currently, we should probably level this up to 10. And we should get it up to 20, to be honest. But before we do, we need to get our dexterity up as well. Because there is some stuff we gotta do with our dexterity later on. And I've been contemplating what to really do with our spec. I've been playing through the DLC. And man, sorceries in those DLCs, not really optimal, to be honest. I think we need to rethink our strategy a bit later on. But I'll find some cool weapons to try some stuff out for you guys. And see how things goes. So we have a couple of options right now. We could continue the Lost Bastille. We have one boss left there, one of the great ones. So we have three of the great ones left, since we have defeated the Duke's dear Freya and gotten the rare soul from her. We could also continue up Earthen Peak. And we also can go to... we have one more boss in Huntsman's Copse, and we have this hole down there in Majula. Decide what to do, we want to go back to Brightstone Cove so we can check out what it was inside that little door on the top of the building with the spider boss. So before we do anything though, remember to light the torch because those spiders will mess you up, trust me. These spiders, man, so annoying. We could also turn in the souls we got from the Duke's dear Freya in the store there, or to Ornifex. But we won't do that just yet. I want to do something else first. And by the way, I've been thinking about what to do with my excess Lord souls. Well, not Lord souls, but boss souls. And I think I'm gonna spend them on basically gaining more souls for the weapons I'm not gonna use, because there isn't really a point to... So this guy should probably just die. There we go. Just taking care of that guy because he is fairly annoying. But let's take care of the spiders though before we open the door, because we want to clear this room out anyway. Because I want space to talk to you guys. Don't want to be interrupted by these fellas. Ooh. Luckily, they are so weak when it comes to fire. And I think that's a nice change because the spiders in this game, they are really annoying. The ones in Bloodborne, oh my god, those are annoying. But yeah. Oh, hello. He must have followed me. Yeah. Oh, let's shoot him down, though. Doom. There we go. There are some more here, but let's not care about those. So this is the door that the key opens. And inside, we'll find some nice stuff. Oh, he dropped down when we did the door. That's not... I didn't know that. Oh, well. And this room is obviously a trap, so you gotta open this door here with the Brightstone Cove key. And once we are inside, we'll see a chest. If we go to the chest and open it, there will be an ambush, basically. As you can see, there will be spiders here. Whoa! Spiders! Shooting the spiders! But yeah, with a torch, it's not really dangerous, except for the moment when you open the chest and the torch is removed temporarily, so that's when you need to watch out. But yeah. So inside this chest, we'll find a Black Knight Ultra Greatsword, Great Fireball, and Fire Seed. Now, Fire Seeds, I don't think I've talked about those. They are upgrade materials that we can use to upgrade our Pyromancy Flame. A Pyromancy Flame serves as the catalyst for Pyromancies and scales the strength of each spell according to its level. Fire is a common object of worship, it can never be grasped, and its mystery stokes the human imagination. So yeah, we can use those to upgrade our Pyromancy Flame, though I don't think I'm going to do that in this playthrough. That depends on how I decide to spec my character. We also got a little more impressive weapon here. We got we previously found a Black Knight Halberd, and now we got the Black Knight Ultra Greatsword. Really nice Ultra Greatsword made by the knights who served a Lord of Light in a long forgotten age. Even after their flesh was charred by flame, they remained as strong as ever and stood watch, challenging visitors to their land. This sword looks freaking amazing, and if you play Dark Souls 1, you know the significance of these Black Knights. Let's see how it looks. Oh my god, I love the design of this sword. Look at that one. We need to get some better lighting. Need to get out of here to see this blade. And it has, actually, I think it has fire damage. Yeah, it has fire damage. I think it's fire damage. Yeah. Requires 30 strength and some faith as well. So I guess you need to be believed to actually wield this weapon. Yeah. Look at that one. Wow. Pretty amazing blade. And it has like I am not strong enough to wield this thing, but in two-handed it has the swipe strike. Oh. Let's not get killed by this freaking spider, though. Let's try to use the blade. It's really terrible for us, though, so let's not. And I slow roll with it as well. That's pretty terrible. But it's really heavy as well. It weighs 18. So, yeah, let's not mess around with that one too much. So that's what's behind the door. Now I'm going to go on to the next area that we are supposed to travel through. And I've thought a lot about this. I don't want things to be too easy early on in the game, because I don't want to basically breeze through everything. Am I being followed? I think I am. No, I don't. That doesn't matter. Yeah, I don't really want to be flow through like early game content later on in the game, so we really should progress through the Lost Bastille, because that area is fairly easy. But we have one Fragrant Bunch of Yore. That's nice. I could go to Lost Bastille. But the reason is one thing I want to do first, though. I want to go to Majula, because there are some stuff down in the well that I want to get, and they are fairly easy to get to early on in the game. You can go down there even after, usually people go there after killing the Dragon Slayer, why am I leveling up now? Don't have enough for a level, sorry. But we should really spend our souls, so let's use some of these. Let's use like three of them. Is that enough for a level? 3,000? That's enough, right? Come on. I need one more. It was too close. Come on! I pressed leave and then opened my start menu. But we should really spend our points, because it's really easy to die here in the next part, because we are going to basically fall down into a pit. So, that's not enough either. There we go. So spend your points now, yes. Because if you lose your souls, you'll be angry at yourself. You don't want to be angry at yourself. You want to be happy. So. Yeah, let's get our soul spent so we don't have much left. And now it's a good thing to remove a lot of your equipment if you're heavy. We aren't really that heavy, but we are wielding a staff and a shield. And we are fairly heavy as well. So let's equip the Royal Soldier Ring. This will decrease our equipment load by a tiny bit, not that much, but a tiny bit. Let's also remove the coveted serpent ring. And we want to use the silver cat ring now because it reduces fall damage. I also contemplated using the slow fall spell, but I don't think I bought that actually. So what you want to do here is that there is a way to get down here without jumping and without buying the ring. We could go and unlock that right now. But I want to show you the jumping method first, though, and then I'll show you the other method later on. So this you can do as early as after the Dragon Rider or the Last Giant when you can afford the ring. First thing you want to do is you want to jump down to the middle platform here, and you'll lose a ton of health. Don't worry, you get some radiant life gem here if you want to regain your health. But let's just Estus up. How much does our Estus recover here? That's nice. But you want to heal up to max. And now the platform next is down there at the glowing corpse here. Pharaoh's Lockstone. That's really nice to have. Now there are a couple of paths here we can take. You can go over to this one, or you can jump down to this one. You want to go to this one first, so you don't lose all your health, basically. Now this is a tricky jump, because you have to jump across to the other side. What you want to do is you want to let's see if I make this. By the way, so if I fail this, then I have to do it again. It's not a far way to run. So you want to run across this small platform here and jump against the wall. That's how you get to the other side. So let's do that and. What happened to my voice there? I have no idea. But yeah, it doesn't matter really. We were in human form though, so we'll lose our humanity, but that's it. We have enough health. You want to be in human form and doing this because you need to have your health basically topped up to survive the falls. Basically, the first one is the most brutal fall. So you want to keep that topped off, I mean. So yeah, but that's the hardest jump that you have to make. So, but it's not that far down, to be honest. I don't think you really need to use the Estus Flask more or an additional Estus Flask. But yeah, so let's try again. You want to edge it. There we go. You want to turn your camera towards the right just at the last second there. Now we have two options. You can jump down to the left or to the right. We're gonna do to the right now because there is some interesting stuff here. That I will explain to you guys later on. This is the Grave of Saints, and if you remember the Doors of Pharos, you remember this cave entrance here with the rat face. And this is part of the Rat Covenant, the Rat Covenant place. And there are two places like these in the game, Doors of Pharos and this, the Grave of Saints. And this is one way to proceed through the dungeon, and I'll show you that later on. I'll do both of the rat covenants in one episode, I think. Now there are a couple of ways we could go down. You could jump down there, that's not advised. You can also try to jump down on the other side, and as you can see there's a ladder there and a locked door. We don't have the key to that door yet. We will get that eventually in the next place we are going down below here. But yeah, let's go back to Majula, and we have to make the jump once more to get to the other side if we don't proceed through this rat cavern, this Grave of Saints. So yeah, now we have to do the jump once more. This is going to be fun. Let's see if I mess it up once again. And down at the bottom, there is some interesting stuff for us. The next area down there is fairly dark, so you want to have your torch. Let's see, how long does our torch last now? It has 1 hour 21 minutes on it, so you want to have at least 30 minutes on your torch if you want to go down here to the next area. And this is also an area which you get rewarded for lighting all the torches, or you get punished depending on how you see it. Let's try to make the jump again. Oh, there we go. Yeah, getting practice on this jump now. And now you just have to fall down on this side here, so be careful. Luckily, there aren't those dumb rocks that we fought in Demon Souls, where there's like a protrusion in the wall, messing things up. But yeah, just roll over here to this one, and let's jump down here. And now we did all the difficult jumps. Ring of the Evil Eye plus one. You can buy the original Ring of the Evil Eye from Shalquar. But this one is a little better. It refills health when you kill enemies. So yeah, let's not fall down here. There we go. Homeward Bone if you want to get back up. Not that we want to, but if you are low leveled, this place here could be quite challenging. Let's just say that. So yeah. First of all, here we have one of these guys. Let's use our Soul Spear on this guy, just to make sure we kill him. Because I don't want to go up here again just yet. This thing usually... Oh, we got a Dark Knight Stone. We haven't gotten those yet, I think. Nope. Abuse equipment with dark. So it was made by the Melfian Academy. Someone must have succeeded, though. What else would explain this stone? This item usually falls down through this this bridge here and lands down in the water below. So don't fret if that happens. You can't get to this item over there just yet, because there is a way to get down here, as I said previously, and that involves some of this bridge above us. But we want to jump across to the platform or to the chest over there if we can. There we go. You can't jump over to this one from here, so don't even bother. But in here we'll find Ash Knuckle Ring. This one is pretty shit, but it was really helpful when the bug was active. This increases petrification resistance. A knuckle ring worn by Roy the Explorer increases petrification resistance. Petrification is tantamount to death, and in that sense, this knuckle ring is a charm that may save your life. So, if you're up against Basilisk, this one could save your life potentially. Not that I get petrified a lot, but you want to jump down here, and immediately you'll be invaded by these. Oh, I used a soul spear there. Didn't mean to do that. You'll be invaded by these enemies here. These were a lot worse in the original Dark Souls. Be sure to stand here on the ground, by the way. Don't stand in the water. But these guys, they explode, so you want to roll backwards when they do this, and they die immediately if you just roll backwards. So that's how we handle them. Or if you're a caster, just punch them with your spells, I guess. There is something over there. As you can see, there is a Scion Knight there, so we can take care of him, and he is guarding something nice. Great heal. That's nice of a miracle. Only a select few have learned to recite this epic romance in its entirety. So, yeah, there you go. He lost a lot of health from our magic there. Boom! Soul Vortex actually working this time. Thank you. But in here, this is not a mimic, by the way. This is some good stuff for us. Sublam Bone Dust, baby! Now we get SS Flask for +4 already. Really good to have this... to have our SS Flask upgraded this far so early on. It's going to be amazingly well for us. And now we're basically done with the hard part. This is the easy part. This place here reminds me so much of the entrance to Blighttown from... don't use the ladders here too much, by the way. You want to save some time by jumping. There are some platforms here you can only jump to, so be aware of that. Because underneath here, I think, there is... an item that you can only get if you jump. Not really that it's that important, though. I think I missed it, actually. Yeah, it's up there. But yeah, this place reminds me of the depths entrance to Blighttown in Dark Souls. Really, really reminds me of that. There the item is. I think I just missed it barely. Let's just roll down. Because of the rafters here. And this area is fairly reminiscent of Blighttown, of Dark Souls. Because it involves basically going through the darkness, and you don't see much. There's some shaky building rafters and stuff like that. So yeah, it's fairly reminiscent of both Blighttown and of the Valley of Defilement in Demon's Souls. So yeah, down at the bottom here, if you don't have a torch, it's easy to miss this chest. So let's just get this. I don't think there's anything good here. No, Token of Spite. Yeah, this one is actually really nice. You get these proof of defeating another world's monster, but this one is another way of gaining one of these. And it's a token recognizing that the owner has traveled worlds to defeat others. When used, you are more likely to summon invaders from other worlds for a period of time. Simply carrying these tokens shows the bitterness of the grudge the holder has accumulated. So you could invade other people and you'll gain those souls. That's basically the Red Phantoms. We'll get to that covenant eventually after the boss in Huntsman's Cops. So here, these statues, we've seen these before, these were up in Majula, and we've seen something similar in the Lost Bastille, but these guys, they shoot poison at you. So you want to make sure you have those poison moss there. If you don't, then don't fret, you will die from poison here. There we go. Don't fall down there, by the way, you got to retrace all your steps here. You want to jump down to this platform here, don't fall down there, go into the hole here. Just play it safe, and then rest at the bonfire. Yeah, there we go. Now we are in the gutter, the upper gutter, more precisely. This place is so dark, most people are pretty tired of going through here, but with a torch, everything will go smoothly. As you can see, the walls here, freaky looking walls. But there are torches here, and you want to light all of these torches, because there will be an NPC that only spawns if you loot all of these. You get a dung pie that's basically shit, literally. A large excrement, still rather warm, thrown at an enemy to cause rapid onset of poison. But you too will be subjected to the same bane. Most warriors are loath to come near the thing like this, much less carried around, but therein lies the advantage. So you could actually poison yourself. Ooh, look at this, I haven't noticed this, but yeah. This was a place where people basically threw down all their shit down in Majula. And we are just below what it was in the pit there, so... Yeah, you can't go up here, this is a shortcut back to the bonfire, by the way. So yeah, this is where they threw all their shit and corpses, and there are lots of dead people in there. Fairly reminiscent of Nito, if you remember from Dark Souls 1. And there are enemies carrying torches around here, just so you can see the... Ah, man, I missed that place. I always do. I always fall down here. And there are some traps like this all over the place. But if you go back here, this hole will be gone. Oh, my torch went away when I did the backstab there. Didn't mean to do that. But yeah, I'm going to use the torch through this entire place because I want you guys to see what actually is going on. So that's the main reason why I do it. But this place was designed, I think, to be played through with a torch. Poison throwing, nice, really nice. Yeah, here you gotta make a jump. You gotta jump across over to that platform over there. So it may look a little bit farm for you, but yeah, you can if you don't mess up the roll there. So yeah, you gotta make an effort. And if you're not sure about how to do the jump, just homeward bone back to the bonfire or die, potentially, if you don't have a lot of souls. And then just don't fall down into the hole again, and you'll be fine. There's some stuff up there for us, but I don't think it's open for us just yet, because it is locked by the same door. Or is this here? I think it's here. By the same contraption that locked the door in the pit we were previously in, with the top on the top of the ladder. So yeah. These torches will stay lit, by the way, but they will, yeah, the door over there, it's the same one as the one we found in the pit. These torches will stay lit, even if you go away from this place and homeward bone back or rest at a bonfire, so. But if you use a bonfire aesthetic or start New Game Plus, then they will disappear, basically. You want to jump down here. If you listen closely, you can hear some enemies in the distance. And be careful with your footing here, because it is easy to fall down. This room I hate. And we get the Dark Pyromancy Flame, and this is a really cool item. You can get this... Oh, hello. You can get this super early on. And it is arguably for classes that don't invest a lot of points into intelligence. This one is a little better. As you can see, it has S scaling in fire. But it scales with hollowing. So if you are very hollowed using the cling, the ring of binding, and you stay hollow all the time at max hollow, this Dark Pyromancy Flame is really nice because it deals more damage the more hollow you are. So a flame catalyst used for Pyromancer. Pyromancer arouses this flame to produce various fire arts. The flame rewards those with a thirst for power. The more hollowed one is, the stronger is its effect. That's really interesting as well. So the more hollowed you are, the more power you have. Oh well. This place, you don't want to break these kegs here. And there's a huge dog there. He's really slow though, so don't really mess with him. There is a torch next to him. Just let him break the kegs, because if you touch these kegs, or these hearts, it looks like, your equipment will degrade and you'll basically be left broken. So literally, in the literal sense of the word. To just get out of this room here. I think I got hit there. But your weapons won't break, though, luckily, in the Scholar of the First Sin Edition. Nothing more in this room, I think. There are some more hearts up here, but yeah, don't really bother with that room, to be honest. I don't think there is anything down there. And these hearts are really, really annoying. They were placed here to be, like, I guess, challenges for a Scholar of the First Sin Edition, so... And those dogs are really slow. So here we have two options. We could jump down here and start all over again. Let's not do that. Let's get back up to the top. And those will stay broken, by the way, if you break them. So they're like poisonous barrels of poison, I guess. But if you if you travel to another place through the bonfire, then you will reset them. Smooth and silky stone, really nice. Human effigy and twinkling titanite, smooth and silky stone again. We can trade those in later on. Fragrant branch of yore, that will be useful for us. Very, very useful. Now we can jump down here. That's the path we're going to take. Let's just see if there's anything I missed. I don't think there is. Oh yeah, the torch here. Forgot that. Almost forgot that torch. So yeah, I'm being very careful with lighting these torches. Oh my god. Yeah. But if you got the poison resistance ring from... Oh my god, I forgot about that one. And that one as well. So be careful. Now I'm back here. But if you found the poison resistance ring, you probably should have gotten that one in the bottom of Earth Antique Peak before the Covetous Demon. That will be very helpful in this area here instead of wearing the freaking cat ring, the silver cat ring. Why am I really wearing this right now? I don't really think I'm going to bother changing it up though. So yeah. Don't really bother going back there. Not really a point to it, to be honest. So let's jump down here. Now we'll be at the place with a couple of these torches here, three. In the original Dark Souls, there were a lot less torches here to light. There were like one here, I think. And we can go back through over this bridge here. And let's take care of this guy from range, because I don't really want to take any risks out on these bridges here. As you can see, there is some light down there. Interesting. But now we'll be back at the top, almost at the beginning of with the first with the bonfire. So I think this is the place you arrive if you just don't deviate from by being trapped by the falling floor. So all of these guys will wake up, I think, or at least some of them will when I light the fire. So be careful about that. And there's also this dog. These dogs are really worthless. They will hit you very hard if they get to you, but they are so slow. So yeah, just you shoot them with your whatever you got, or go in with a melee with behind them. They are really helpless if you go in from behind. Let's go back here. Be aware that these are so annoying. Well, let's go up here first though, and there is some loot there. What are you doing? Stop it! Stop it now! Oh yeah, I almost forgot this chest. Inside we have a black firebomb. Yay. You can use those firebombs though to destroy the the huge corrosive hearts we found previously, or you could use them to destroy these this poison shooting statues. That's also an option. Oh my god, that was too close. Or you can use throwing knives on these. I think throwing knives works. Let's try one throwing knife out, just see if it, yeah, they work. So by the way, this one at the bottom, really annoying one, be sure to break this one at the ground, because it will shoot you immediately when you go up the ladder, so yeah. But yeah, the only problem with these statues here is that your weapon will be degraded, basically, or the durability will, and there's an ambush going on over there. And I always forget how to get over there, but I think this is the path, the correct way. We also forgot to loot that guy, but they don't really drop anything useful. To be honest, light the fire, and over there is the path. Wait, we were just there, weren't we? Huh, interesting. They are coming for me now. Maybe I missed some path over there. We'll go back and investigate that later. Yeah, even though it's not really that important, to be honest. Yeah, but over there, that's the path we want to go to. Not to proceed the level though, but there is some secret over there. Yeah. Then the torches are a really nice way to know if you've been to a place or not. So they are sort of a way to mark your progress down here. So that's nice at least. So the torches do have like a secondary function. But you are limited if you're... Almost fell down. That would have been terrible. Would have been boring. What are you doing? That was the worst torch... Like... What... Yeah, what's the room down here? Can't really remember that room too much. Yeah, this place always confuses me. That's the path we came from, and this is another guy. Oh, that was one of those exploding fellas. Yeah, they start coming eventually. But this is the path you want to take to proceed the level, and I'm going back to the bonfire later on to show you the rest, I think. These guys were added in the Scholar of the First Edition. Really annoying enemies. They are like blood leeches that weren't introduced until I think the first DLC. but they hit fairly hard, so you want to be careful because they do this jump smash attack. So yeah, like this. Ah, I thought they had poisoned as well, but I guess I'm mixing up with oh, golden fruit bomb. Mixing them with the mosquitoes in Blighttown. So we got the golden fruit bomb. Temporarily increases faith. This special fragment, a fragrant oil, affects your mind, granting a fleeting sense of empowerment. So it's basically a drug, making you believe in something a little more. Might be useful, I guess. But in here, I don't think there's anything in these barrels here. But in the chest, we'll find Wicked Ad Great Shield. This was part of the shield design competition before the game came out. It's a great shield. Oh, lost the torch there. That doesn't really matter. With an eye on, and its super attack is to you can absorb basically the health of enemies with that shield. So yeah. Let's get our torch lit again, though. Luckily, the torch is, since you have the torches lit. Oh, not gonna use my staff on that one. But luckily, those, since the torch has been lit already, we can just relight it from these other torches. We're lighting bones on fire, by the way. Like we do on the bonfires, which is interesting. I don't really think bones are flammable, though. He got ready to pounce on me, gotta be careful with that. And I'm just gonna break all of these, not gonna take any chances. We're almost at the at the bonfire now, though, so it's through this this fog door, if you can tell. And the other side there will be a bonfire for us. Be careful not to fall down into the middle, though. Before we do anything, we want to go over here. And we'll be this area is really, really weird. This guy, he's so friendly. These poisonous guys, not so much. They're basically just protecting the big one. Yeah, these are actually scarabs, or not scarabs, but I guess cockroaches with a big mushroom on their head. But this guy, if you stand in this cloud, nothing really happens to you. But he can cleanse you of stuff, and he's actually a friendly NPC or a parasite. But he will attack you if you get close or if you try to attack him, so he's pretty strong. But he can cleanse you of poison and stuff, so yeah, that's what he does. So if you get poisoned, just walk into this cloud. Don't really bother killing him, though. He doesn't really give any souls or anything. So it's a really strange NPC there. But if you get affected, I don't think he can cure curse. No, he can't, because in this game, curse isn't like a status effect. It's basically just removing your humanity, I guess. But in here, there are a lot of paths down, and there are lots of ladders. And we are basically done with this. Proceeding through the area. We have some stuff more to do here before we go on, though. These guys wield these dark weapons, which hurt your stamina fairly hard if they hit you. You want to break these planks here, and there is torch and a bonfire over there in the distance. So yeah, and remember that all of these statues, they will stay broken if you light a bonfire, but if you travel, they will reappear. So we can rest here, regain our Estus, and we can see what's going on. And yeah, as you can see, this statue is broken still. So there are a couple of ways you can go down this path. As you can see, there are lots of ladders. I usually tend to go to this one first. There is one out here to the farthest right, not this one, but this one over here. Because there are some items down here, and there will be some falling and jumping down here, so you might want to be a little careful. As you can see, there are a couple of paths we can take. And that ladder goes down to... Hello? You want to join in on the party? Yeah, there is... I mean, don't think there is an item in that, barrel over there. But we can jump down to this path if you want to just light this fire. And that will make things a little brighter down here, which would make it easier for a second. Not ascension, I guess, but a second descension. Ooh, a second descent. That sounds like a good movie. Second descent, the first reborn. Oh wow, that was generic. We could go down to the bottom here, or we could go back up. There is some treasure here over on the other side. I can't really remember if they are any good, though, but we want to light all the torches anyway, so. As you can see, there is a way to fall down through the flooring there, or I think that is a way to do that. But yeah, to get to that place over there, I think you should really jump from that ladder below, or ladder above there. You don't want to make the jump from here. So we want to make our way over to the ladder over there in the corner. This place, yeah, not really that good. But yeah, this ladder behind there. That's where we want to go. Rolling, rolling, rolling to the path we want to go down. And this is the path we want to take. So, what? Jump down and... Oh, I was standing on top of the pot. Break the item. Rotten pine resin, not really useful. Now we want to jump down here, I think. And we could jump down there, or we could get the chest. I think we'll get the chest, to be honest. Because we can just take that path down later on. Oh. And now inside here, we'll find Great Club. And this is not the same as the club, I think. We have a club as well. This one is two-handed, has B scaling and strength. When not fully upgraded, I think it goes up to A or S scaling. A giant wooden club made from the branches of a towering tree, designed to smash foes. Simple, but terribly effective against common shields, so it has high poise damage. Let's make our way to the bottom now, because there isn't really a way up for us. From here, at least. So, yeah. By the way, the rest of this episode will be me finishing up this entire area. So if you're curious about that, then keep on watching. If not, then we'll go to the next area in this zone. In the next episode, so that's good, right, guys? This area, some people might think is a bit boring, but yeah, and I think it's a little daunting, a daunting task as well, because it takes so long to go through. But oh well, the path we are going to take is through there, by the way, so you want to break those with something. You could use magic, I think. Doom, doom, doom. You want to have some ranged stuff. I think you can use arrows as well. Or maybe only heavy... No, crossbow bolts work. And also, I think regular arrows work on those hearts as well. Which is nice. But now I'm going back up to the top. And then we're going to do some more jumping. So I think this is the easiest path, to be honest. That's the one we went up previously. Let's take this one just for the sake of change. The sake of change, a life story. Changing the lives of hundreds of people every day. Making sure that life stays brilliant all night long. That sounded like something erotic there. Let's just check this one. I thought there was something in that. No, there is nothing in that barrel there. Then we would see the glow. So nothing really too important there. I think this is the path we want to take for the last bonfire, or the last torch there. Don't really think there is one over there. Nope, there is not. Come on! There we go. So, let's light this baby up, and we should go down to the next area. Woo! Yeah, I gotta make this this part a bit more... I gotta be a little more... roll down here, and we get some Fragrant Branch of Yore. Now we have two of those. That's nice. Two Fragrant Branch... Three, I guess. Oh, that's gonna be useful. Down here, you'll see these same statues, but they are glowing green. Someone has, like, yeah, messed up there. Thrown up all upon dumb statues. And through here, we'll get to a really interesting area. The Black Gulch. Whoa. This place is really cool. And there are two bonfires in the Black Gulch. We want to cover those later on, because now I'm going back to the first bonfire in the upper gutter. Now, there are no lower gutter, by the way. This is the Black Gulch, which is basically the lower gutters. That's where all the shit basically turned into poisonous stuff. Let's continue across this path here, but before we do, let's light the torch. Lighten the torch. And yeah, that's where we fell down previously. Now we can make our way across this path over here. And I find it to be actually useful to fall down through there at the first time you go through this place, because you will be able to get to the main goal of this area a lot quicker if you do. Yeah, this is the part I'm not really too familiar with, because I usually just skip this place because I can't really remember if there is anything useful at all through here. But as you can see, if you go through here, you can just jump down to those three torches there, and you'll save a lot of time there. So if you want to speed run through this area, don't fall down into the hole. But I find it nice because we get the dark pyromancy flame and stuff like that, so that's nice, and that's good to know, right? So over on the other side here, you can see a path going. Ooh, should we jump over there? Not yet. We want to explore a bit more first. Break this one, it'll shoot at you in the back. This one will shoot as well. Ah! You see the shot there? It didn't even come from that one. I think this guy will. Oh, he didn't light up. And now we can see that's the opposite side from where we found the treasure. And yeah, we can jump down here. I think this is where we're going to jump down, to be honest. Let's try that out. And over here... Oh, these guys! I didn't know these guys spawned here. They are freaking horrible. They will jump and grab you, and they will kill you. So you want to be careful with these guys. Don't take any chances. They jump up from those tar pit holes, and they try to grab you. And previously they didn't spawn here. These were added in this Scholar of the First Sin edition, I believe, because I can't remember them being here. But yeah, you want to clear these guys out. I think there might be a couple more. Well, are there? Are there? Hello? Oh! I forgot that those are tar pits, so if you touch them with fire, then everything will burn. That's good to know. So you can go down here. I think this is the path forward that we want to take. Let's light the torch first, though. And as you can see, we can just jump down over there to get back to where we started this place off. So my goal is currently to light all the fires. I think you can... No, you can't break those. I thought you can. I thought he could. Gotta use my grandma's. Oh. Some angry fellas in there. Let's try to use the soul vortex against these guys and see how that goes. If he didn't just burst me down, though. Oh, my God. Really annoying fella. Don't want to die now. Come on, heal me up. Luckily, they die really easily, so that's good. But yeah, you want to be careful with those kamikaze zombies. Kamikaze hollows. Don't really know the real name, to be honest, but yeah. Sorry, Mr. Hollow. There we go. And I know there is a torch that we have back at the shortcut back home to the bonfire, so that might be the last one. Nothing else in there. There is a ladder up here. Ooh. Climbing all the way. There really isn't any point of going here, to be honest. Just beside... Besides, like, lighting all these torches. I really find this area to be quite laborious. And, yeah. There is this chest, though. I almost forgot that chest. Jump over here. Ha! There we go. And inside, we will find... Or we've been invaded by Melinda the Butcher! We got the Ring of Soul Protection as well. So, yeah. That's good, at least. But, yeah, she's up there. And she's a recurring character, if you can tell. She was in Demon Souls, and she was in Dark Souls as well, but she wasn't called Melinda back then. She was called... let's light these on fire, by the way, so we can maybe trick her into walking into those, I think. Yeah, she's taking damage, look at that. So that's one easy way to kill her early on. Just light these things on fire and just kite her through them. I think that's a great way to kill her, to be honest. She is fairly dangerous, though. But... We are super strong, so bye-bye, Melinda. Whew. Has been vanquished. Oh, yes. Human effigy. Hey, we got some souls there. 12,000. Not too bad, not too bad. Is this guy? No, he won't turn alive. He won't return to life. Let's light this one. I think these will ambush me. Not really sure. Let's just... be safe here. I think we missed like one torch or something. I think we've missed like one torch. Oh my god, I think we missed one up there, perhaps. That's really annoying. You know what, guys? I think I'll retrace all my... Oh, there it is, maybe. Oh, I used the soul spear to break that statue back there. That wasn't really nice at all. Is this the last torch? No, we still have one, some more left. You know what, guys? I'm gonna cut here, and then I'm gonna turn back the recording when I find the last torch. Okay? So I want to see this happen. because I've never seen it before. I've never bothered to light all these torches, and I've heard something is going to happen. So guys, I jumped down here to the place with the dog that I don't think I had visited before. And there are tons of those guys on the opposite side. I think maybe this one is the last one. Nope. Okay guys, I have one more thing to check out before we go, and that's the place on the rafters just below before we jump down to the bonfire. And that's the last place I need to check if there is a bonfire or if there's a torch up there. Because I've gone through a lot of the entire gutter right now, retraced all my steps, and I found one of those torches that we missed, but I'm not sure where the last one is. So before I want to go down into the well again, though, let's burn our bonfire, our bone dust, and then level up a bit at the Emerald Herald before I suicide jump down into the well of eternity once more. Yeah, lest this land swallow us whole. So yeah, more dexterity there, 2 levels, that's great. Level 90 as of this point. As you can see, the levels in this game, they go by quickly. Compared to Dark Souls 1 at least, where levels were a little more, a little rarer, I guess. In Dark Souls 2, you'll be at, a soul level really high very quickly, so. You'll be at soul level very high. That's basically the best level you can get to. Yay, I made the jump. Ooh. And it, by the way, if the torch isn't up there, then that means that the torch is inside the place where that was locked by the door, same as this one in the pit here. So that is the only place I haven't searched through, so it has to be there. And if not, then I was probably wrong with the torch thing. But yeah, it'll be at least it will be bright and sunny downstairs, which is nice. You know, it will be bright in the gutter. Those hollows there having a good old time with some light now. Can party and go on a torch adventure. Wait, it has to be down here, right? It has to be. Come on. I'm starting to feel like this will be the bane of my existence right now. Yeah, this is the quick way to go down. These ladders blocking my rolling all day long. Gotta be careful though. I don't want to die here. Yeah, we can jump down from here. Perhaps we have to use the flame butterfly, and I just missed this one previously. That's like a thought, because I was like distracted by all of these freaking poisonous massages. I almost said massages there, but it doesn't look like there is anything here. No, doesn't look like to be a torch here. Nah. Well, not up here either. Nope. Oh. Maybe here. This is the area here. I've never ever been here. I have no idea. Why is this place even here? Come on. Is there a treasure here? No. This place serves no purpose. Is this a shortcut down? No. Probably not. Now I can't get back up there either. We can jump down there though. Okay. Well, let's jump down. There we go. Okay guys, that was the gutter. I think we discovered everything down here. At least I went through this place like 3 or 4 times. In the next episode, we will be going to the Black Gulch, and we'll see some funny stuff there and fight some more in this episode, and we'll defeat some bosses next time. Ooh, see you guys then, guys. See you guys. What was that? Well, that wasn't a good exit there. See you guys next time. Bye.